好啦，终于去到戏玉啦。如果坚持要个岛沉咗落海咧，加上有较多嘅考古证据咧，我个人认为咧就系、是、西班牙西呢个嘅地方。咁我。第一次去了解到这个有可能是亚特兰提斯的位置呢，是透过漫画。那你不要看小日本漫画，他那个的搜证，他的资料搜集吓死人。这个日本漫画叫做亚特兰提斯之谜入此堂见闻录漫画。那他那个资料搜集非常之好。那啊，最后呢都是导引到我们呢去这个西班牙西的地方的。那当然啦，我的结论梗系唔系只系建基于一套漫画啦，咁最后都有呢个纪录片嘅。咁呢个纪录片咧，都系同漫画同一个结论啊，就系、是、咧西班牙以西咧呢、这个沼泽地，咁依家咧其实系个国家公园嚟噶。咁样。
But in 2004, a young German physicist named Rainer Kuhn made headlines by using satellite photography to resurrect the Bonser-Schulten theory.
I am here within the mud flats of the Donana National Park. It is exactly here where I think that Plato's Atlantis was located.
Dr. Kuhn observed strange circular patterns in a satellite photograph of the Donana mud flats, giving exact dimensions for each. Kuhn believes that the circular patterns he's identified match Plato's measurements.It seems a low-tech strategy when compared to satellite photography, but by attaching cameras to balloon and kite, the team can acquire much higher resolution images than the photographs taken from space.
And see whether those rings really exist.
We're going to lift the balloon to at least 100 meters, and then we'll probably work at different increments of elevation, 100, 150, 200, and so forth.
Man-made structures.But if there was once a mighty city here, what happened to it?
Yeah. The picture right here at the higher altitude, you may see this rectangle that we were talking about.
If they can find circular and rectangular patterns, they believe they will have strong evidence pointing to the footprint of a lost city.
This particular feature was not included in our list, so this is new that Paul's photography has revealed to us.
And this area has been cleared by the grass cutters for thatch. And even after clearing, the feature was still visible from the kite photo. It's clearly not just a feature that's visible in vegetation, but visible in the earth.
Is this the Atlantis footprint that Plato described?
This is, I think, the most important feature in the aerial photography that's been done. It's the one that most resembles anything like Atlantis.It has an area that looks like a port leading into a large circle where the concentric circles would have been.
Freund is convinced that the photographs reveal a pattern that matches Plato's description, a series of circular harbors with a central canal connecting them to the ocean. And the team has identified more intriguing features.
Circular features, linear features, parallel features, all in the order of a human scale. So for instance, things that look like pathways or roadways that are a meter to 2 meters across, features that look like buildings that are 4 to 8 meters across.
The rings of Atlantis existed in this ancient bay and were ravaged by successive tsunamis. The city would have been torn apart or perhaps pulled into the sea. As a result, evidence for the lost civilization may not just be under the Donana mudflats. It may be underwater, further out.Off the modern coast are employing the latest in side-scan sonar technology generated and bounced off the seabed. The signals are received by the computer on deck, which converts them into images.
We have seen an anomaly, which is a vertical wall. This is very different to a geological formation.
Magnifico.
It is a vertical structure.
Approximately 12 meters below the surface,Divers discover mysterious formations. stones that seem to have been cut. Could these strange features point to something more than geology?
Fíjate que eso fuera una pared, un bloque hecho por el hombre. Parece un muro, pero yo veo dentro de la piedra y veo líneas. Yo no veo un muro, yo veo un estrato diaclasado. Este diaclasado corresponde a esfuerzos regionales y seguro, vamos, yo apostaría que es geológico.
Yo no puedo afirmarlo con rotundidad, pero me cuesta creerlo, ¿no? Me cuesta verlo. Parece que puede ser una formación natural que haya sido modificada. Parece que el hombre ha hecho algo ahí.
Que alguien aprovechara esta piedra que se la encuentra rota para construir un muro. Puede ser.
The team now employs electrical resistivity tomography, or ERT, to record images of what is deep below the circular patterns.
That there were actual signatures of walls that were located below the surface. And we have a mysterious methane layer that was sealed about 6 to 9 meters below the surface. It goes down
the objects, but also because the content and style may represent a direct connection to the great civilizations of the ancient world, from the ancient Near East through the Aegean to the Mediterranean.
And those two small figurines can connect it, because if we find the culture that fits into that context, then we found Atlantis.
Tarshish is a city mentioned many times in the Bible. And many scholars believe that Tarshish is simply another name for the ancient and famous city of Tartessos.
Most scholars agree that Tartessos was located in southern Spain and that Tarshish was located in southern Spain. Tartessos was Tarshish.
It is documented that trade ships would embark on 3-year journeys from the Middle East to fill their holds. Surprisingly, Tartessos and Tarshish disappear from the historical and biblical records. It's as if the city suddenly ceased to exist.
咁我再提啦，有考古发掘遗迹，有喺海边，有环形建筑，有丰富矿产，又近呢个直布罗陀海峡。用柏拉图个八点去形容呢个亚特兰蒂斯咧，其实呢个西班牙西咧 ，Donana National Park， 咁我系简称 Donana 或者叫西班牙西啦。咁、这个西班牙西咧就符合咗柏拉图所描述亚特兰蒂斯都我谂都有五六点嘅 ，OK， 未必系完全符合晒，一阵间我会解释。尤其是个环形建筑咧，最后咧佢就话系发掘唔到。有得可惜啦，因为佢依家嗰个嘅地段系沼泽区啊，有好多地下水啊，你好难去挖掘嘢出嚟，因为你要抽干地下水，咁你点抽干得晒咧？又咸水又淡水咁样样，好难搞。而喺地表上面揾到嘅人类工具痕迹咧，就只系有两个好细嘅神像啫，咁又系证据唔够嘅，咁所以咧，佢进一步嘅证据系欠奉嘅。咁我好欣赏呢套纪录片咧，佢用好多科学嘅方法咧，去逐步逐步去寻找地表啦、地土泥层之下有啲乜嘢啦，或者如果真係有洪水冲击嘅时候咧，沿岸嘅海床有啲乜嘢啦。只可惜咧就係佢嗰个嘅发掘嘅规模咧就太细啦，揾到嘅嘢咧都係好有限，所以咧仍然都係停喺一个理论嘅层面。他们无论在地表或者近海岸的海床找到的东西其实都有限。举个例子，在沿海那里会找到一些似是人工建筑的直线咯等等。他说用了3日星纳探测10公里平方范围，发现到海底12米之后有直伸墙。当然啦，如果刚才我们用回究竟是人工还是天然呢，咁如果我哋純粹揾直線嘅話，就當係嘅話，咁就會揾到人工建築㗎啦。咁但係如果你再係將個條件 set 高啲，咁話要揾到係人類建築嘅痕跡 ，OK， 可能有容器啊、有釘啊、有錘啊、武器啊、城市結構啊等等，咁就好可惜，我唔知係咪 budget 所限，咁呢個紀錄片咧就冇再提供進一步嘅實質嘅證據啦。咁所以咧，有時嗰個究竟係人工啦，定係大自然，係 man-made 定 natural 咧？有時都好難去有一個清晰界線。特別係如果話係有一啲嘅建築特色咧， 是加建在是人工人为的加建在大自然的巨石上面的时候呢，那你更加难定义到那些人工的大自然咯，因为都冲刷晒了。不过呢这个地方呢起码我都坚信了是有三四年，我觉得这个都似的，因为真的符合了柏拉图所形容的嘛，有环形的东西，有证据啦，考古证据啦，有运河啦等等啦，咁同埋佢又好认真，有电子绘图、高空卫星图像等等啦，咁同埋佢又话揾到咧有啲土层有甲醛，咁甲醛就系证明咧生物一次过被覆盖嘅时候咧所遗留落嚟嘅气体啦，有生物嘅痕迹啦。持平啲讲啦，虽然呢个纪录片咧佢嘅搜证方法咧系好科学，但系仍然有几个摆不位嘅。咁第一个摆不位头先讲咗啦，佢嘅发掘出嚟嘅证据其实好有限。第二就是咧，其实个时间性咧唔系最夹。
Carbon 14 dating has told us that artifacts found inside of the marsh go from the period of 5,000 BCE all the way down to approximately 2,000 BCE。
咁纪录片所讲咧，碳十四研究呢个 Doana 嘅土层历史咧，只系得公元前5000年至到公元前2000年咁耐啫。就遠比於柏拉圖所描述的在他的時代是的公元前9000年是爭了太遠了，如果計算柏拉圖的時間的話就是公元前12000年的了，那現在那個西班牙西呢只不過是公元前5000年而已，那還爭了成5000年以上的時間，時間不合。第三個敗不位或者是較說服力不足的呢，就是那个 Donana 西班牙西，他另一个的古名叫 Tarshish。
Professor Freund believes that's because in ancient days Tartessos and Tarshish went by another name, Atlantis。
We have two remarkably... 但是那个 Tarshish 研究员认为呢，古名就跟 Atlantis 是一样，同一个意思，那就这个就真的信不信由你了。即如果我觉得更加有说服力就是呢，呢个 Donana 个古名就系 Atlantis， 咁就真系中啫。咁但系原来佢个古名系 Tarshish， 然后你话个 Tarshish 就系等于 Atlantis 咧，我就咧觉得太快咧跳到去结论咯，同埋咧佢都赖到去圣经嗰度。圣经有讲到呢笪地方就系最后消失咗。咁当然啦，究竟系咪圣经讲呢笪地方咧又消失咗咧，咁有得拗啦。咁最后咧，因为进一步嘅考古证据欠奉啊，咁啊佢嗰个嘅教授咧。就在內陸裏面就找到一個叫 Ritual City， 就是一個的祭祀的城市，他就說是一些亞特蘭提斯人，即是生存下來的難民呢移入大陸，他們呢起了一個這樣的城市為了紀念亞特蘭提斯的，就是當中有護城河啊等等。但我覺得最大敗北是什麼呢？ 我自己覺得是一來你沒有進一步的考古證據了，因為礙於budget，還有那個發掘艱難，二来就似即系骑虎难下，即系佢哋咁确信成个发掘西班牙西就系亚特兰提斯，即系佢哋都唔会讲，亦都唔敢讲，亦都唔想讲嗰度可能唔系咯。即系你可以讲话嗰个系纯粹一个其中一个古城市冇问题噶，因为头先都有好多唔同嘅古城市系浸咗啦，譬如个海盗港啊、亚历山大港啊等等。咁如果嗰个纯粹真係个时间性係都係9000年之前一个嘅古都市被沉没，唔出奇嘅，我都相信係坚嘅，因为有考古发掘，但係咪一定係亚特兰提斯呢？讲真係证据不足嘅。但係就好明显啦，教授就我觉得夹硬嚟嘅最后。同埋最夹硬嚟呢，佢就话嗰个纪念城市呢就係纪念亚特兰提斯，有咩有啲符号诸如此类啦。但是个符号都可以解读过一个人拿着个盾嘅啫，未必即系话守护住呢个亚特兰提斯城。但我觉得最败笔系，如果系要纪念亚特兰提斯，点解嗰个嘅神殿啊，唔系环形建筑咧，唔系圆形咧，系方形咧？即系我觉得系自相矛盾咯。所以最后咧，我觉得个结论系不值所限，同埋亦都唔敢讲，嘥咗咁多钱之后，原来揾咗唔系亚特兰提斯，咁唔敢咁讲啦，顶硬上点都话系啦，咁样啦。咁我哋咧呢、這个冷气探险咧，就暂时咧就嚟到呢个西班牙西啦。咁但系当然啦，我哋未去到最高峰、最高潮。